Theorites, Tales of 1001 Nights Volume 2. By anonymous author. Audiobook 13x70. He accepted the gifts, treated the messenger honorably and prepared a splendid present for his son-in-law, which he sent back with the messenger. On his return the man told the prince how pleased the king of Sana had been to receive news of his daughter, and the prince, in his turn, was delighted to hear this. The prince wrote every year to his father-in-law and sent him presents, and they continued in this way until the prince's father died and the prince succeeded to the throne. He treated his subjects justly, and the prince succeeded to the throne. He treated his subjects justly, conducting himself in a way that won their approval, exercising authority and commanding obedience throughout his lands and among his people. They continued like this, enjoying the most delightful and pleasant of lives in luxury and health, until they were visited by the destroyer of delights and the parter of companions. Praise be to the living God, who does not die and in whose hands lie power and sovereignty. A story is also told that once, long ago in an earlier age, there was a great king, a man of power and authority, who had a vizier named Ibrahim. Ibrahim had a daughter of remarkable beauty, unrivaled in the perfection of her loveliness, outstandingly cultured and of great intelligence. She had a fondness for wine and drinking parties, as well as a liking for handsome faces, elegant poetry, and witty stories, while her innate grace moved men to love her. She was as a poet described her. "I am in love with the greatest enchantress among Turks and Arabs. She argues with me on religious law, grammar, and literature. I am the grammatical object," she says, "but you put me in the genitive. Why is that? This is a subject, so why is it in the accusative?" I said to her, "My life and my soul are your ransom. Do you not know that time is full of changes? If you find yourself doubting this, see how the head of a sentence can be fitted to its tail." The girl's name was Alward Fialak Mam, a name that she owed to her delicacy and the perfection of her beauty asterisk while because of her mastery of literature she was a favorite drinking companion of the king. It was a habit of his every year to gather together the most prominent of his subjects for a game of polo, and on the day that this happened she was sitting at her window to watch the game. While it was going on, she suddenly noticed among the players a surpassingly splendid and handsome young man, bright-faced with gleaming teeth, tall and broad-shouldered. She looked at him.